terms of communication, what do physicians want patients to do during their visit with you? Like, what do you look for in your patients? What do you hope they'll bring into the visit?
Yeah, what's really important to me is that they are comfortable to bring up the questions that they have and what matters to them. And I also want them to feel comfortable about telling me honestly how they really are feeling, because we make our decisions based on how things have been since the last visit. So we need an honest appraisal of what's been going on. They have to be comfortable telling me, no, things are not going well, if they're not going well.
So why is a comfortable or sort of quote-unquote safe environment important for good patient-physician communication, Dr. Lacay?
A patient has to be comfortable with their physician in order to really bring up things that matter to them and to be able to have an effective communication. So it's all about developing that relationship and that rapport that puts the patient at ease.
So in terms of communication, what do physicians sort of want from their patients? What do you, for example, Dr. Lacay, what do you want your patients to bring into the clinical visit in the way of communication?
Yeah, what really matters to me is two things. One is I want them to be comfortable asking me the questions that they have and the things, bringing up the things that matter to them. And then the other thing that's really important to me is that they be comfortable really telling me honestly how they've been feeling since the last time we saw each other. Because the treatment decisions are based on how they've been doing. So they need to be honest with themselves and honest with me about how things have been so that we make the proper decisions.
Right. In this communication, how much is nonverbal?
Oh, so much is nonverbal. I mean, the figures state 80% of communication is nonverbal. I'm looking for, are they really engaged in the conversation? Do we have eye contact? I look for their reaction on their face. So there is so much that is told on these nonverbal cues that are
right.
So important.
What then are some of the signs that you see in your patients that kind of forecast not a great visit?
Yeah.
Well,
the worst is if I sense them being disengaged. I look for their emotions on their face. So if I see the emotion changing, there can be things that are clues to them becoming disengaged.
Yeah. What are a few things you recommend to patients to prepare for their medical visits? I think this is such an important question to know the answer to for patients.
So I think a few things are helpful to prepare. One of it is knowing what medications you're on. It's also helpful if you've thought ahead of time about how have things been since your last visit. And then lastly, the other thing that's useful to prepare ahead of time is, do you have, you know, what is your list of questions for today? What are your concerns? And, you know, to be realistic with the time frame, maybe prioritize them. So, you know, what are your top three questions or concerns that you want to raise? And
right.
Be prepared ahead of time for them.
Does a patient have the right to copies of their records?
Oh, definitely. So a patient record belongs to the patient. And the records that are particularly useful for patients to have access to is the results of their lab tests. Mm. And many provinces actually have a system by which patients can directly access their lab results, which I really encourage my patients to do. And I also like to go over with my patients, what do I look for in these lab tests? Because they're a little bit intimidating for the patients. So any results of, let's say, imaging or any tests, those are all things that I think are useful for them to keep track of, you know, if they have a little folder of their medical information.